The Philippines, a nation of over 7,000 islands, long at the mercy of the ocean's power and the internet's fragility. But now it's flipping the script. Beneath the surface of Asia's most volatile waters lies a hidden threat to global connectivity. And one earthquake can bring entire economies to a halt. In 2006, it did. Today, the Philippines is fighting back with a bold, game-changing project, the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure. It's not just a fiber cable, it's a lifeline. A new digital highway is rising, faster, safer, and earthquake-proof, reshaping the country into Asia's next digital powerhouse. From underwater disaster to digital resilience, this is the story of how the Philippines is turning dangerous waters into digital opportunity. Let's dive in. But before we do, kindly like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. The Philippines, a country known for its stunning stretch of over 7,000 islands, is now turning that scattered geography into a powerful asset in the global digital game. At the heart of this transformation, a groundbreaking project called the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, or LBI. This isn't just another fiber optic upgrade. The LBI is a bold, land-based internet superhighway that smartly avoids one of the world's riskiest undersea cable routes, the Luzon Strait. Why is that important? Because the Luzon Strait, tucked between northern Philippines and Taiwan, has long been the main pathway for underwater internet cables connecting East Asia to the US and beyond. But there's a catch. It also sits on a major fault line. One strong earthquake here, and internet across the region could go dark. And it's happened before. In 2006, the Hengchun earthquake shook the sea floor, and with it, the digital backbone of much of Asia. By rerouting around this digital danger zone, the Philippines isn't just dodging disaster. It's stepping up as a key player in building a more resilient, future-proof internet for the world. Back in 2006, a powerful undersea earthquake didn't just shake the ocean floor, it shook the digital world. That single quake triggered massive underwater landslides and density flows, snapping 22 submarine cables in an instant. The result? Widespread internet outages and slowdowns across the Philippines, Hong Kong, Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, and more. The fallout was massive. Banks froze, stock markets stalled, and the Philippines' fast-growing outsourcing industry came to a screeching halt, costing the country billions of pesos over just a few weeks. Why was the impact so devastating? Because up to 11 major internet cables were packed into one vulnerable route, the Luzon Strait, creating a dangerous single point of failure for Asia's digital traffic. That's exactly why the Philippine government stepped in with a game-changing solution, the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, or LBI. Instead of risking everything on the unstable seafloor, LBI reroutes internet traffic over land, safely across Luzon Island, bypassing the fault zones entirely. It's not just smart, it's a strategic move to protect the Philippines' digital future and help secure the internet backbone of the entire region. This major project, led by the Department of Information and Communications Technology, DICT, and the Bases Conversion and Development Authority, BCDA, is reshaping the Philippines' digital future from the ground up. Here's what's happening. Two brand new cable landing stations are being built, one on the East Coast in Bel Air, Aurora, and the other on the West Coast in San Fernando, La Union. These stations are connected by a 240 to 250 kilometer fiber optic corridor that runs across Luzon Island. The price tag? Around 975 million pesos. That's roughly 18 million US dollars. But the payoff is big. This route offers a safer, more climate-resilient and future-ready path for international data cables to land and exchange traffic in the Philippines, all while avoiding high-risk earthquake zones. And here's where it gets even more interesting. Some of the biggest names in global tech are already on board. Meta, formerly Facebook, was the first private partner to connect its Pacific Light Cable Network, PLCN, to the LBI. In return for access, Meta provided the Philippine government with a dedicated fiber pair. That one deal alone boosted the government's data capacity from 40,000 megabits per second to the equivalent of 2 terabits per second. That's 50 times more bandwidth and almost equal to what the top 2 telecom companies in the country combined could offer at the time. The message is clear. The LBI isn't just a new internet route. It's a digital game changer for the Philippines and a major step toward becoming a key hub in global connectivity. Leaders have called it a game changer, and for good reason. The Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, LBI, promises faster, more reliable, and more affordable internet for everyday Filipinos. But here's the bigger picture. LBI is just one part of a much larger national plan to transform the Philippines into a major digital hub in Asia. The project is fully integrated into the government's national broadband plan, and it works hand in hand with the rollout of the National Fiber Optic Backbone, NFOB, the country's largest digital infrastructure push to date. Backing it all? A massive 268.22 million euros, about 287.24 million US dollars, loan from the World Bank, approved in October 2024. And this isn't just about better internet speeds in cities. It's about connecting over 20 million Filipinos, especially those in rural and underserved areas, with high-speed, disaster-resilient broadband. This backbone is being built to last. We're talking buried fiber conduits, reinforced data stations, and materials tough enough to stand up to typhoons and floods. A must in a country that faces extreme weather every year. So while LBI is a critical first step, it's just the beginning. Together with NFOB and the National Broadband Plan, the Philippines is laying down the digital foundation for an inclusive, future-ready economy. One that brings every community, no matter how remote, online, and into the future. At the same time, the private sector is stepping up in a big way, adding even more momentum to the Philippines' digital transformation. New undersea cable systems like Jupiter, Bifrost, CH2X, and Apricot are expanding and diversifying regional data routes, creating alternatives and reducing bottlenecks. Local telecom giants are also making bold moves. PLDT and Converge ICT are investing heavily in strengthening domestic internet infrastructure. In fact, Converge alone is putting $1.8 billion on the table to expand broadband across Luzon and beyond. Using the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, LBI, and National Fiber Optic Backbone, NFOB, as the core foundation for that growth. Together, these public and private efforts are creating something the country's internet system has long needed: redundancy and resilience. By moving away from relying on a single undersea choke point, the Philippines is building a more stable, scalable connection to global data networks. The Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, integrated into the National Broadband Plan, marks a major turning point. What was once a fragile setup, vulnerable to earthquakes, underwater landslides, and limited routes, is now evolving into a strong, future-ready digital network, built to withstand shocks and meet growing demand. In short, the Philippines is no longer just playing catch-up. It's building a digital backbone that can lead. One that connects more people, powers more industries, and puts the nation firmly on the global tech map. By building a land-based alternative to the unpredictable Luzon Strait, the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, LBI, eliminates what used to be the Philippines' biggest digital weak spot. Now, even if the seas are shaken by storms or seismic activity, millions of users across the country can stay online and connected. And the long-term impact? It's huge. From a security standpoint, the LBI gives the Philippines a major upgrade. Not just a physical workaround, but a geopolitical advantage. In a region known for earthquakes and territorial tensions, the country now has a reliable, stable communications lifeline. When it comes to capacity, the numbers speak for themselves. Through partnerships with global tech players like Meta, the government secured a dedicated 2 terabits per second fiber pair. That's 50 times more bandwidth than it had just 10 years ago. That kind of leap isn't just impressive, it's transformational. But this isn't just about faster streaming or quicker downloads. That bandwidth is powering free public Wi-Fi, digital learning in classrooms, telemedicine for rural health centers, and the nationwide rollout of e-government platforms that bring vital services directly to remote barangays. In short, LBI isn't just a new cable system. It's the foundation for a more connected, more resilient, and more inclusive Philippines. One where every Filipino, no matter where they live, has a digital future within reach. From an economic standpoint, the Luzon Bypass Infrastructure, LBI, and its linked subsea cable landings are a game changer, making the Philippines a much stronger contender as a digital hub in Asia. This boost is already attracting major investments in data centers, content delivery networks, and international peering points, all critical pieces that will firmly anchor the country's role in the global internet landscape. But the LBI is more than just a big infrastructure project. It's a bold statement. It says loud and clear that the Philippines won't let its geography dictate its digital future anymore. By combining redundancy, capacity, and resilience, Manila is building a solid foundation for sustainable digital growth that will pay off for decades to come. The message: the work is just beginning. To keep this momentum alive and growing, the Philippines needs ongoing investment, careful maintenance, and strong public-private partnerships. If they get it right, the country can lock in its spot as a resilient, connected, and competitive nation. One whose digital lifelines won't be at the mercy of risky waters or natural disasters anymore. From facing seismic risks to building digital strength, the Philippines is showing the world that geography doesn't have to define its future. The Luzon Bypass Infrastructure isn't just a cable route. It's a powerful symbol of what happens when vision turns into action. With every mile of fiber laid and every rural community plugged in, the country gets closer to a digital future that includes everyone. But the journey isn't over yet. It takes continued investment, fresh innovation, and strong teamwork between the public and private sectors to keep this progress rolling. If you believe in a connected, competitive, and resilient Philippines, smash that like button, subscribe for more deep dives into tech and infrastructure, and drop a comment below. What does digital resilience mean to you? Thanks for watching. Stay connected, and we'll catch you in the next video.